Everyone, welcome back to Let's Play Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess. I am SIMSteven, also known as Master Fenrel. In the last episode, we had just arrived here in the Kakariko region. Well, actually, it's more the Elden region, but Kakariko Village is a major part of the Elden region. And, well, we dispelled the twilight that's surrounding this area, and so now we've been tasked with a new objective to go and try and see if we can smooth things over with the relationship between the Gorons and the people here of Kakariko Village. Because they were friends at one time, but the Gorons themselves had encountered some problems of their own up on Death Mountain, and so because they had their own problems, well, they need someone to mediate between them. And, well, I guess we volunteered, even though Ronaldo, the shaman of Kakariko Village, said that, you know, it's really none of your business, this is our problem, and we shouldn't really be dealing with this. But because we are the brave hero that we are, we're actually going to try and do it ourselves, to see if we can get the Gorons to listen to reason. So, if we go off to Death Mountain, the way we came from before, and we'll see, hey, there's a Goron! No humans allowed! So, they are just going to try and push us away and get us out of here. So, not much you can do here. In fact, as soon as you talk to this guy, the best thing to do is run away. Otherwise, you'll take a little bit of damage. But, I'm going to show you what happens if you do just try and press on and get past this guy. This land's head belonged to the Goron tribe. The other said, no humans may pass. So, yeah. No trespassing and all that. So, yeah. Oh, I guess you can't run away. So, that was a prompt similar to when the goats were escaping from the ranch back in Ordon Village. I didn't even bother pressing A, but he'll just knock you off no matter what, because Gorons have great strength, and so we do not have the ability to match their strength as of yet. So, weak spirit is no match for the might of the Gorons. Do you understand, human? Then away with you. Right, so now that we've done this, all we can do right now is turn back and head back to Kakariko Village and see what Ronaldo has to say about them. And he has apparently followed us all the way up to here. Either way, have fortune. You're in one piece. I saw you heading up the mountain trail, so I was worried. They try to reach the Gorons of Death Mountain is far too dangerous, Link. They recognize only strength. A normal person could never persuade them. But I do know one person who was able to best them and earn their trust. His name is Bo. You may know him as the mayor of your hometown, Ordon. Please go to him, and while you are there, please let him know that children are safe. Alright, we'll do that. Everyone back at home is worried, after all. So of course we're going to go over there. Anyways, of course, getting him back would be best, but we could not keep them safe from the monsters on the road without a horse and a cart. Please return to Ordon and inform the parents that their children are free from harm. Give them my word. Well, save for Ilya, because she's the only one in the group that we haven't found as of yet. So, I guess the mayor would be very upset to hear that we haven't found her yet, but the other children are safe. So I guess everyone else will be okay. Either way, it's best you turn in. Okay, so we probably gotta go ask the mayor of our hometown. So let's get going. Oh, and before we go off there, I wanna see if I can stop by Barna's Bomb Shop and see if I can get something out of this place. Naturally I wanna get bombs, of course. So let's see if we can. Are you gonna sell us some stuff?
Cripes, my storehouse, my powder, what happened? Them foul beasts, curse them all!
So, he's upset over the fact that, well, his storehouse has been blown up. I won't tell him if we were the ones who were responsible. Actually, you know what? We weren't responsible. All we did was light those bugs on fire, and then they lit the bombs in the house up in. Blew it up. We aren't the ones at fault. We were just trying to save the realm from Twilight. And oh, hey, look at this. If we walk down the road after talking to Ronaldo, looks like Epona has returned. And she's going to jump the gate back where we were. And, well, uh-oh, she's going wild, running wild. So let's see what we can do to calm her down. After all, we're the horse wrangler of our village, so... Calm down, Epona, calm down! So what we gotta do here is a bit of a mini-game. Just follow the prompt at the bottom of the screen. Hold the joystick left or right to hold on. Just do this until you get the A prompt to seize Epona. If you fail to hold on and miss the prompt to seize, then you'll just get bucked off and have to try and remount again. But yeah, she was obviously upset because it's been a long time since she's had... since we disappeared and, you know, the bald ones attacked us back in the Ordon Spring and then she ran off. So now, finally, she just comes out of nowhere and we got her horse back. Yay! You're not so shabby of a wrangler after all. Well, this making back to your town a lot easier. Yeah, I'll go finish your errand and... so we can get back. Get a move on. Alrighty then, let's get a going. Yeah! Alright, so this was kind of a selling point for the game, but we've never really been able to experience it till now. And one thing they really touted when they were making this game is that horseback combat has been greatly improved in comparison to previous games of the series. There wasn't much horseback combat previously. We saw a bit of it in Ocarina of Time and Majora's Mask, but the only thing you can really do while you're on a horse is pull out your bow and shoot things. But now, you can pull out your sword and swing around, you can pull out, you know, your guild and ring. You can pretty much use almost every single item in your inventory and use it while on horseback. I think we can even use the lantern. Yeah. Oh, I don't want to waste my... oh, put it away, put it away, put it away. Okay. bad idea, but let's see here. I think we'll head to other things we could potentially get. I do believe we bought the bottle of lantern oil from, I think his name is Goro once again. Yeah, I think I remembered that just after the fact. I didn't really look it up or anything, but I'm pretty sure his name is Goro here. But yeah, I believe we've gotten that bottle of lantern oil. In fact, there it is right there. What else have we got? I don't know. I think I'm gonna get the lantern off of my active equipment so I don't accidentally use lantern oil, because I'm going to definitely need some later in the game. And, well, with how my recording setup is, it's a little bit darker than what my TV is set to, so... I'll be making use of the lantern a little bit more than I normally do in a usual playthrough, because, well, I can typically see things a little bit better when I'm playing on my normal TV. Either way, we're going to make a pit stop here at the Ordon Spring. No, not because I want to check to see if I can get the Shadow Beast once again, but when we were dispelling the Twilight as Wolf Link, we listened to the Howling Stone. And, well, our little golden wolf friend came here to the Ordon Spring and is hanging off just aside here. So, we know what this means. We can get ourselves a new sword technique. And this will be our second one. The first one was Finishing Blow. And I forget what this one was, what this next one was, but we'll find out. Hello, Mr. Stealthos, yet again. You would have a little more of a look of hero than you did before. Do you feel ready to earn your next skill? I do. Very well, but before we begin, I must test you and ensure you have mastered the last skill I taught you, the Ending Blow. Oh, I thought it was Finishing Blow. Now then, come at me! So, we gotta repeat what we did at the end of the last trial, and knock him down, and then press the A button to finish him off. So, we'll try and see if we learn our next skill. Excellent. Appears you are certainly capable of performing a lost art. Very well. My second skill is the shield attack. Let it be hewn into your mind. matter how well-tempered a blade is, if a foe is clad in armor and bears a shield, a sword will do it no harm. When facing such a foe, you must use R to thrust your shield against the defenses of your enemy, causing the fiend to recoil. Use L to lock on to me, and then try it. You have learned much, so I'm sure you'll see the moment when you can do the shield attack. Alright, let's get this going. So, lock on with L, press R to hit him with your shield. You can also attack him after he's been knocked defenseless, and they'll allow us to proceed to the next step. Excellent. Open a hole in your enemy's defenses and use your sword to strike without hesitation. Shield attack, I just taught you, can also be used to repel an enemy's projectile attacks. When you practice and repel my magical attack, your shield attack R. So, you can just press R when that magic ball is coming at us and deflect it back at him. Kind of reminds me of how it's come back in Breath of the Wild once again. Great way to take out guardians, by the way. Perfect. When your enemies assail you with projectiles, this is how you defeat them with ease. Done. You've learned the second of my hidden skills, a shield attack. I love that pose, by the way. Even though we don't have a sheath, as I said before, I don't know where he put his sword into. You learn the second hidden skill, a shield attack. Lock on your foe with L and press R to thrust your shield, dazing your enemy. But I have 5 more secrets to teach you in time. The path to becoming a true hero is a long one, but once you have pressed all the hidden skills, you shall be worthy of walking it. You must persist on the lonely path of the sword, attain true courage, and earn the strength to conquer the great evils of the world. Discipline with the blade before we meet again. Right. Seen that several times. We're going to be seeing that a lot, I guess. that's done. We got ourselves a new skill. Let's not even use it for a while and go back to our hometown and have a peaceful reunion. So, I think this will lead us right back to our house. Back to house and home. And there's something here I forgot now that I'm thinking about it. Back in the beginning of the game, probably even the first episode, I pointed out that there was something in the basement of our house, and I don't even think I picked it up when I grabbed the wooden sword a little bit ago. But there is something I want to get with this new item. So I'm going to be double-checking to see if I can collect it. I'm pretty sure I haven't done it yet, but let's go back down into the basement. Pull out our lantern. Okay, so it seems we've got a bunch of knickknacks here in the basement. And you cannot actually get this treasure chest even if you know it's here, unless you have the lantern equipped and turn on, of course. But yeah, we got a bunch of stuff here in the basement. Crates and pots, and I didn't know Link was a heavy drinker. yeah, there's lots of little things down here in his basement, and it's actually a rupee that belonged to us, but it was 50 rupees, so good thing to keep for the road, I suppose. But for now, we don't have anything else to do here inside Home Sweet Home. So let's get right back out on the road. And I'd also like to make sure to bring Epona all the way back to the ranch, because there's also something we can get there. And we'll also make sure to visit with everyone once again, because we shouldn't be just telling Mayor Bo about, you know, the children being safe and all that. We should tell everyone. We should hear it from the man ourselves. But first, I think we got some work to do. Unfortunately, Mayor Bo isn't letting us go back that way. Oh, it is you, Link. You're safe and sound. Ah, he's returned as well as we. If you remember, last time we visited before going off to the Elden Province, or was it the Forest Temple? Mayor Bo had been out searching for the children, but fortunately we didn't cross paths, and so, yeah, he's been out of the house for quite a while, but now we're back, and this is his first time learning that we're back safe and sound, and we actually survived the attack. He's probably the only one who doesn't know at this point. Either way, your clothes, what happened to you, lad? Come quick, inside. Alright, so we'll get off Epona for now. And have a chit-chat with the mayor.
I see, so the youngins are in Kakariko Village. Well, that's good. Renato's an old friend. If they're in his care, then we can relax.
So don't keep me waiting, lad. Tell me my little girl, Ilya's with the rest of them, right?
No. Oh, I see. That ain't what I wanted to hear.
But Link, I guess I need to think of all five of those poor kids. Not just my own, they're all in danger. What I should be asking is how I can help out.
Well, in that case, we heard you're quite strong, Mirbo. What's that now, the Gorons of Death Mountain?
I see, so Renato told you that.
Well then, it's true. I did defeat the Gorons in a contest of strength and earn their trust with the help of a little secret. I can teach you the secret, but can you promise me that you absolutely, positively not disclose it to anyone?
Sure.
Okay, good. Alrighty then. Absolutely no one.
Come this way. Link, you heard of sumo wrestling, right? The Gorons like to match strength in sumo contests. Luckily for you, the bases of sumo are the same as stop and charge and ghosts. Want to hear more? I guess that's kind of why we got thrown off there and had that whole prompt there back when we were up against that Goron. It's the same thing all over again. So let's hear more. Alrighty, I'll teach you the basic ways of sumo. If you're getting in a sumo match, chances are you're in an arena like this. The first fellow to push his foe outside the arena wins. Step forward and grab your foe with A. Use B to let retreating foe taste your open palm. Sidestep the foe's advance with left or right. Three techniques, all of them pretty basic. Master all three and you'll be shoving folks out of the arena in no time, lad. So there you go, the basics of sumo. And you hear him get, No. No more tutorial, thank you very much. Rather than explain a lot, why don't we just get to it? Come into the ring, lad. Alright, so we're going to be doing sumo wrestling. You can tell this game was made in Japan, huh? So, this does not seem like a fair fight, because the reason why it's a thing in Japan is because they actually trained for this and build up their bellies and all that. And I think Mayor Bo is probably at least 400 pounds, and I'm probably, what, 150? yeah, this is like a heavyweight champion going up against a featherweight. So, it's actually pretty easy. You want to stay in the middle of the arena at all times if possible. And if you get hit by a slap, you want to mash the A button. Try press B to slap him. I'm going to try and move to the side and slap him once he fails to do a grab. And if they're moving to the side like that, you can hit him with B and then grab him and push him out. So that's our tutorial out of the way. It's kind of like a game of rock, paper, and scissors. I know I kind of did that a bit fast, but basically the slap, which is the B button, beats sidestep. The A button, I believe the sidestep beats a grab, which you hit with the A button. And I believe the A button is just used to push him out. I believe the B might stop the grab, but I'm not entirely sure. I forget what one beats what, but I'm pretty sure A beats the slap. Regardless, I don't know. I forget what all the rules. Basically, the trick to doing it is make sure you are not with your back too close to the edge of the ring. You always want to be moving to the side. And we hit each other with a slap. And, well, he countered my sidestep with the, with his slap. But if I manage to sidestep, I will typically slap and then grab. Okay. Can I sidestep? Alright, okay, so A beats, the grab beats, actually beats both sidestep and, the grab actually beats sidestep and slap, because you saw it there just a second ago. but I believe slap will also stop the sidestep, and really, I think as long as you can get your opponent off balance a little bit, either by sidestepping and then grabbing, or slapping and then grabbing, you can push your opponent out of the arena. So, I guess we showed him what's what. We're a quick study. With your natural talent, I'm sure you can take on the Gorons. But that didn't seem much like a secret. He was wanting to, you know, make sure our lips are sealed about a certain secret he had, but he wanted to make sure we're ready for the ring first. So, what is the actual secret? Well, he'll tell us in just a second. You've got a sight stronger in the short time you've been gone, Link. Strong as you are, though, you can't hope to beat the Gorons wrestling with power alone. Those Gorons are made of rock. Nah, the secret to beating the Gorons is locked away in that chest. Take it with you, lad. Alright, so here's the actual secret that allow us to beat Gorons in a contest of strength is the Iron Boots. Wear these and you'll become so heavy not even a Goron will be able to push you around. So, that'll give us strong footing, allow us to, well, best the Gorons in a test of strength, or at least they won't knock us off, or, well, it'll give us good footing. It's like a Xenoblade gem or something. you can probably tell those boots are made of iron, lad. Whoever wears them won't be easily pushed around, even by a Goron. Fixing to fight a Goron, be sure to wear those boots. Just be square, though, lad. You can't tell, can't ever tell anyone about those boots, especially Renato. Alright, so we went with the mayor. And, well, yeah, I guess he's reminding us, don't tell anyone about boots. But, I said I wanted to do some work. So, hopefully the opponent is still right there, and we'll be able to take her back to the ranch. Because there's something for us in it when we go there. And I am very close to getting something, and this is exactly what I want to do to take care of this first. Now, I believe we talked with this guy, drawing a blank once again. Wow, I can't remember the names of these people, even though I played this game so much. I'm terrible with names, you couldn't tell. Fado? I forget what his name is. Either way, Link. No fooling, the tots are safe. On top of that, they're in Kakariko Village. Aw, shucks, you don't need to worry about that now. You're incredible, bud. I can already see everybody's smiling faces. Alright, so we told him about the kids in Kakariko Village, and that lifted his spirits quite a bit. And he also sees that we brought Epona along. So, well, how about it? You want to round up them ghosts? First time in a dog's age? I bet these scamps sure are happy to see you. Sure thing. Great, then I'll leave it to you two today. So he's been taking care of the goats while we were gone out looking for the kids. But, may as well do this. Since, you know, we still haven't lost our touch. Let's get these goats in. And let's see. Oh, that was actually pretty good. I got him to go back the way I wanted him to go. Now I think you need to do this under a certain time to get the best reward. So we're going to try and get them all in one go if we possibly can, or get a bunch of them each and every time. And so we're gonna whoop till the sun goes down, I suppose. Can get you guys in. I also didn't get to show this before, but if you mash the A button a little too much and whoop a lot, they'll actually get mad and ram you. So let's try and see if we can show that off with this one here. Let's just spam the A button and see if we can get him angry. I don't know. I don't think he was going to do it. So, three more. Oh, there he goes. Ah! Yeah, I didn't get to show that before, but I felt it was at least shown once. Even though we weren't able to do it in tutorial times before. I got four more. I think all of them are here. I think. So, my recording device started there for a second. I hope it doesn't cause any problems after everything was all done. Two of them didn't want to go in. I don't know why that happened, but... I think we need to be 2 minutes, if I'm not mistaken. So we should be good. If I can just get these two in this pass by. Oh, go back the other way! Back the other way! Back the other way! I don't think we're gonna make it this time. He didn't go the way I wanted him to go. Alright. Whoop, whoop, whoop. Let's go. Let's go. Move, move. Get in the barn. Get in the barn! Hopefully that will allow us to get the best reward, but I think you have to beat 2 minutes, if not mistaken. Who waited? Alright, Link. You read that in just 2:11. Thanks to you, I read things a mad earlier today. He's promised. Here's a little healthy gift for y'all. Good luck out there, bud. Oh, actually, he did give us it. Maybe that's 2.5 minutes. I'm not entirely sure. Either way, that's a piece of heart. And if you remember last time, we had 4 to the next heart container. So, with this, we actually have 5 pieces. That makes us... that gives us another heart container. So, that's a good thing I was helping you... Good thing I was able to wrap it early today. Thanks to you helping me out, bud. Thanks a ton, Link. Alright, so... Let's get out of here, because that's really about all there is left to do. Actually, hold on one moment here. I think there's a little Easter egg back here. Hey! Actually, no, he's not going to do that this time. But it's the postman. We can't just let the goats eat a messy-looking letter like this. Oh, we can just let the goats eat a messy-looking letter like this. I don't know what you're doing reading other people's mail, but ain't that a federal offense or something like that, even if you are the postman? But yeah, he kind of showed... The postman tends to show up in random locations for a reason, and this is one of them. So it's kind of an Easter egg, but I don't know. Speaking of Easter egg, he does have a bunny on his hat, and in addition to that, the postman in previous games has ties to things like bunnies and stuff. Because, if I'm not mistaken, in Ocarina of Time, well, he wasn't actually a postman in that game. There's the character known as the Running Man in Ocarina of Time, and you could give him the bunny hood. And the same character ended up showing up again. They reused the character models in Majora's Mask. But that same character had a lookalike in Majora's Mask, and he actually was a postman. There's also things you could do with the bunny hood in... Majora's Mask. So, oops, did not mean to pull up my letter here, our lantern here, but we got to talk to Ula here. I don't see Russell hanging around anywhere, making sure she can tell us where he is, but first, we can tell her where the children are, especially Colin, since that's our kid. Oh, Colin is alive. Oh, the children are all safe. How wonderful. I'm so glad I kept the faith. My thanks to you, Link, from the bottom of my heart. Have you told everyone else that? You must tell them all, alright? I'm so happy that everyone is safe, and you have really grown to be an impressive swordsman over time. I wish I could tell my husband as well. The moment his wounds healed, he left to find those young ones. Hopefully he will stop by Kakariko Village. Well, if we see him, we'll let him know as well. I do not know his whereabouts, so it may not reach him. I'll try to send him a letter with this fine news. Oh, I must write Colin 1-2. Well, at least the postman is brave enough to travel the roads and at least leave a correspondence of some sort. I guess we're just talking about the postman a lot right here. But either way, who else could we talk to? I guess Taylor and Mayla's parents. And the shopkeeper and his husband. Or his husband, his wife. Now, we'll talk to both of them since they're both, you know, shopkeepers. Link. Okay, so we'll tell him about the children being alive.
The children are alive? What? They're all alive? This is fantastic. Truly fantastic. Oh, thank you for letting me know, Link. Have you told all the others yet? If you haven't, you must spread the word. Please put their worst fears to rest. Have you told all the others yet? If you haven't, you must spread the word.
Okay. Oh, he's just saying the same thing. Alright, so may as well just leave a pawn over there for the time being and head over and talk to... What are your names? Jaggle and Purgies, of course. Yo, Link, what's the latest? Have you gotten any clues where our types might be? Huh? They're in Kakariko. Ooh, I'm so glad they're safe, though. Have nails sleep at night. Thanks a lot, Link. Alright. Anything else to say? Link, thanks so much. I'm going to change my ways before the chum get back. Yeah, I'm going to get starting serious about my work.
Oh, that's a noble goal, I suppose. Make them at least look after you a little bit more so they aren't brats like we've seen them be so far.
Link, thanks so much. I'm going to change my way.
Okay, so he's saying the same thing. Alright, let's go and talk to Purgy, I believe it's her name. I don't know which one is Jaggle and which one is Purgy, so... Yeah, like I said before, even though I love this game, especially this little village here... Oh, by the way, Doggy, let's give you a hug before we talk to her. Yeah, I keep forgetting some of the names of these people.
The children, they're alive! Oh, thank heavens, I've almost given up hope for them. Thank you so much for coming to tell me, Link. Thank goodness the children are still alive. You must tell all the others.
Alright, good, say anything? Okay, yep. So, just spreading the good word, I suppose. Have you heard the good word? No, I am not one of those people. Actually hate those people, especially since they kind of go door to door and force themselves upon you. This conversation has devolved quite quickly. So, let's put Epona right by the exit so we can just get out of here as soon as I possibly can. I want to do this quick because I see that up on my menu. I want to get out there. I don't want to have my lantern equipped anymore, so I don't waste my lantern oil by accident. Alright, let's talk to, I believe her name is Sarah. I at least remember that one. What's that? The children? Oh, so they're in Kakariko Village. Well, thank goodness they're still alive. I was worried sick. Phew, finally I can get back to work in peace. Link, you need some music.
Okay, so, still gonna sell us stuff. No milk. At least her lantern oil is the same price as Goro's, so that's a good thing. At least he's not... you know, cheating is or anything. Of course, I want to come back home as soon as possible. For now, it's probably safer for the folk in Kakariko to look after them. But, hey, Link, if you're going out there again, then how do you travel? Okay, preparations, yada yada. You want to sell stuff? Still, always the merchant. So, at least she's not bummed out. So, I guess everyone knows. I think we've told everyone so far. What is your name again? It's bugging me. Yeah, Fido. Okay. I think I had it right the first time. But enough of that. Enough of me screwing up names. I think we've done everything we need to do here. So, I guess for the rest of this episode, we'll make our way back to Kakariko Village. There's still a couple things we can do in the Hyrule Field. Pretty sure there's not much for us to do out here in Ordon or Faron. So, yeah, I don't think there's anything like pieces of parts or anything that we're missing at this point. So let's just get back to the Elden Province and let's get some collectibles and head back to Kakariko Village, I suppose. And we'll be ready to go back to Death Mountain. Get things going, I suppose. Alright, so, I don't know if there's anything that way back in the forest up region. There we go. Sometimes these narrow corridors can be a problem for getting it through with Epona, but yeah, just turn around a few times and then eventually you'll get through. Okay, so what we have new since our last trip to Hyrule Field.
We have Epona, we have the Iron Boots, and that's pretty much it. I don't think we have any other new weapons, and I don't think Epona or the Iron Boots will allow us to do much else at this point in time. So, yeah, let's just go through to the Kakariko Gorge seamlessly at that. one of the cool things about Wind Waker is how you can go from island to island and have no loading screens. Same thing goes here in the Hyrule Field. As you can see, there was no loading screen during that gorge. It was kind of a soft loading screen because, you know, we were going through with little assets and all that. But enough about technical difficulties. I want to go here first. We never went up this way before as Wolfling, but there is one little thing we can get here in this part of the Kakariko Gorge. And there we go. It's very tiny and hard to see, but on top of that pillar, there is a twirling something or other. So we'll lock onto it with our boomerang and pull it back to us. It's a piece of heart. So we're already getting started on our next heart container after getting the piece of heart back in Ordon Village. Alright, Epona, let's get it going. And we don't have bombs yet, but there are some rocks around here you can blow up for rupees once you get bombs. In fact, we might be able to get bombs just momentarily once we get back to Kakariko Village. There is actually a cave there. I passed by it just a second ago. Actually, you know what? There's actually some bugs here we can get, so let's do that first before we go to Kakariko Village. And around here, next to these trees, around this circle of flowers, actually I think it's over here near this thing here. Yeah, there it is. It's right there on the floor. It is a pill bug. Doesn't move around fast, so you don't have to worry about it getting away from you. So, that's the female version, and I think the male version is actually back over here on this side of the bridge. I think it's just off the side of the road here. I think I just saw it there a second ago. So let's grab you. We'll collect you for later. We can't do anything with these just yet, but probably a good idea to grab these while you can so you don't forget them. And now I think that's all we can really get here in Hyrule Field. So let's go back to Kakariko Village. Use Epona to jump the fence once again. And make our way back inside the village. Oh. I guess we're not going to do any more collecting because I know what's coming up next. We see Tailwind Beth just hanging out by the village entrance, and it's the King Boblin himself. They're at it again. And Tail is about to run. He actually does run, and then Colin takes a look and was like, you know what, I should get away. Beth? What are you doing standing there? Beth, get out of the way! He actually pushes her out of the way, and King Boblin doesn't exactly trample Colin, but he knocks him out and grabs him. It's like, hi there! I lift my mask, you lower yours. Yeah, you fear me, bud? You fear me? Uh-oh. And here we come, and now look at Link. Look at how pissed he is. Now he's just edging his son to say, come and get me, bro. Come at me, bro. And Link is having none of this. He's like, I can fight back now, so you ain't getting away. No sense in hanging around here in Kakariko. Let's go this way to the north exit to Kakariko Village. Not to the exit to Death Mountain, but off to the left. I showed this gate in the last episode, and we couldn't do anything about it as Wolfling. Now that we have Epona, we can actually jump the gate. And, well, we get to have a showdown with King Boblin. The first of several. It's like, come at me, bro. And I just pull out my wooden sword, and that was kind of funny. Alright, would have been a lot more epic if we had our Ordon sword, but no. So, as I was mentioning when we first got Epona, we actually have horseback battles in this game. Proper horseback battles where you can actually use your sword. So, we're going to speed along with Epona. And we're going to hold B down to get our spin attack going. And try and let Epona recover a bit. Just get right up to him and slash him away. Slash away. And he's got a bunch of little friends trailing behind us. You can knock him off with your sword. If you knock too many off, they'll just respawn. But if you knock a few, I don't think it'll cause them to respawn. But we're going to try and catch up with the Bulb King Bulblin once again. Let our A button charges recharge a little bit. And get him with the spin attack. And what you really just want to do is keep up the heat against King Bulblin. Now you can see with that last hit, we can actually knock his armor off. And that's kind of the best way to gauge your progress in how much damage you've done to him. And that was great. a good spin attack can knock off a bunch of these Bulblins off their boars pretty easily. But now though, let's get some damage in. Hit him a bunch of times. Now you might have noticed this a second ago, he also blows his horn during battle. And that's just his way of calling reinforcements. If you take down too many, he'll call in reinforcements. But if you take down like one or two, he'll still hold off. So either way, oh, that was a nice counterattack. I hit that arrow with my sword and I just let go of the B button accidentally. But let's get up to him. He's a little too far away for me to hit still. So, nah, I ain't gonna jump that fence, even though I was too far out to the side. I thought I wasn't going to. Still did it anyways. Where'd he go? I lost track of him. Where did King Bulblin go? Where did he go? I lost him. well, I guess I gotta find the one with the stick coming off the back, because that's where Colin is. Well, I guess I'll take you guys out until I find him again. Okay, he didn't go that way, because the gate is still down. That's where the second part of the fight happens, by the way. Yeah, this is really bad if you lose track of him. I don't know where he is. Oh, is he just hanging out over here? Okay. So at least I think that's a good thing. I think if you lose track of him, he'll stop until you come after him again. So yeah, even though he's just trying to toy with us a little bit, he is kind of in this, not for a completely unfair fight, but he will stop and wait for us if we lose track of him. As it's obvious, he's trying to taunt us this whole time, trying to get us to attack him. And we went past each other and I missed him. Let's go. Let's get back to it and beat his fat ass. Alright, and he wants to jump those fences, doesn't he? Charge of the spin attack. And that was enough. I only needed a little bit more before I lost it. But anyways, after you beat him enough, all of his armor comes off, and he'll actually go through this gate here, and Link will automatically follow him to what is known as the Bridge of Elden. Of course, we're on a giant bridge, and this is the Elden province. But, well, this is pretty obvious what happens here. One of those Bulblins just blocks the way behind us, and so now we joust. So this is more or less nothing more than a game of chicken. We come after each other and hold down B, go one way, and unfortunately I went the wrong way. But basically what you want to do is charge up a spin attack, and as you get close to him, you want to go one side or the other. and use a spin attack. And that should be enough. If you get him, get a hit with the spin attack, you should be able to damage him. Now, if you get off early enough, I think you can actually get a good hit. That was me that time. Thankfully, I had a fairy in the bottle. Good thing to have. I've had that since right before the Diababa. But either way, we got him that time. So basically, once you reach the end of the path, Epona will automatically turn around once he reaches the path, and it just repeats over and over until you beat him. I probably wouldn't have needed to use that fairy unless I had, actually not lost track of him during the main fight, because I took a little bit more damage from the Moblins while I was trying to fight him again. But either way, we win, and we do the whole, two-legged horse kind of rearing its back in the middle of the sunset, even though that was more like the Twilight Wall. But, Collins? Alright, I suppose. I think we're back in Kakariko Village as we talk to him here. But yeah, we saved him. I don't know quite exactly how things worked out from point A to point B, but everyone's just kind of looking at him, and we're hanging out here in Kakariko Village. Yeah, Colin was a little bit of a hero because he saved Beth. And, good. Beth is alright. Beth, I'm sorry, for shoving you. Are you mad? I think I finally understand. In case you've forgotten, Colin has always looked up to us, and his dad has been trying to teach Colin bravery and strength. And he's been trying to teach Colin lessons of what it means to be a hero and swordsman and all that, and just to be stronger in general. And now Colin has finally understood what his father has been teaching me, because if you remember right, Colin was very apprehensive to, be a sword fighter. He just wanted to be like us, but he didn't want to be, a sword fighter. He wanted to be strong like us, but not, actually throw himself into danger and become a sword fighter. But now he's starting to understand what his dad has been teaching him. And it kind of hit him when he, saved Beth. I understand what my dad meant when he told me to be stronger like you, Link. He wasn't talking about strength like lifting stuff. He was talking about being brave. Link, you saved me, didn't you? Yeah, he was kind of out of unconscious during that whole fight, so he probably didn't see everything that happened, but he kind of understands what it means now to be like us. You could do anything. You could do something to help the Gorons in the mine, too, can't you, Link? And he's out. Now Talo wants to help out, too, after seeing what Colin did. But he's just a kid. Renato's got this. So he's just passed out. He's all right. We'll go and see him in a bit. For now, though, we're going to look up at Death Mountain and kind of see what awaits us. So we're ready to take on Death Mountain, but I suppose we'll take on Death Mountain in the next episode. For now, though, there are a couple things I want to take care of in Kakariko Village. And let's see here. Can we do something here in the shop? Actually, you can see here, Melo's taking over this building here. And he's going to make it his own general store. Yeah, demon baby indeed. He's got something up his sleeve, it seems. Can't believe Colin. I mean, that was really brave thing for him to do, huh? Especially since he's such a weakling, but he is going to be alright, right? And me, though. He hasn't even come to say get well soon. What's he thinking? Said he was going to get started. Hasn't come out of that closed-off ship since. Link, could you talk some sense of that kid? Well, he is your little brother, isn't he? Or is it his sister? I still don't remember if Milo is a boy or a girl. Regardless, let's go inside and talk to Milo. Or can we? Oh, there he is. You can barely see him over the counter. Can we pick this up? Hey. You can take a look at stuff, but don't you dare just take things. That's my valuable merchandise. If you want it, you pay for it. Considering you hijacked this shop, I don't think you paid for any of it either. I decided to take on this unmanned shop. Oh, I gotta get the demon baby voice, by the way.
Buy something! It helps the whole village when you do.
And I am 42 rupees short of getting the Hylian shield, but I will definitely be doing some rupee grinding in a little bit. Actually, you know what? I want to take a look at one thing really quick. Ah, I can hold 300 rupees. So, I think, well, there is a way to get a bunch of rupees right now, but it's going to take a few minutes to do, and I suppose if I have a few minutes, I'll do that in a second here. But first, there are some more collectibles here in Kakariko Village, and I want to make sure to pick them up first. I believe the first one is over in this house, just to the right of Barnes's bomb shop. So if we go in here, this was just an abandoned house back when we were searching the town before. But there's one little thing we can get in here. And I do mean little. It is a female ant. So there's more bugs here in Kakariko Village. As of course, there is also a male ant somewhere in here. And I think if I remember right, it's in the hotel. That big two-section building that we were in towards the entrance. Just right to... the Melo Mart, as it'll soon be known. So if we go in here with the big double doors, I believe the male ant is in here somewhere. If not, there is something for us to see regardless, so it's not going to be a total waste. But if I remember right, the male ant is, I think, over here in the kitchen? Well, the postman is here in the kitchen, so let's talk to him. I dropped a letter in the hot spring, and now I can't read it. Gotta blow this thing dry. What are you doing reading other people's letters, Mr. Postman? Ain't that a federal offense? Alright, regardless. I don't see any ants in here. Can't roll indoors. So I guess we can't break stuff, like crates and pots and stuff. What about behind the bar? No, it's not back there. Regardless, we'll find the ant eventually, but I don't think it's in here, unless it's upstairs. But there is something for us to see upstairs. I remember where the male ant is, actually. We'll go back there in just a second. That's kind of dawned on me for a second there. Anyways, here's Renato. This is where he took Cullen inside the inn. Do not worry, he merely sleeps. So long as he continues to rest, he shall eventually open his eyes. These two are doing a fine job of nursing him back to health. So we got Beth, and I believe her name was Luda? I think that's what her name was. You two, be calm in here. Alright. You can see they're just kind of taking turns. I guess blotting his head with wet handkerchiefs, I guess. Are you going to see the Gorons, Link? I am sorry you have to do this task for us. You'll be here with Cullen, so please do not worry about him. Alright, so, talk to her. Just leave Cullen to me. You'll see Link, promise. I'll make him all better while you're up on Goron's Mountain. Alright, so, he's just kind of here, getting some bed rest. And they're repeating next. Does Renato say anything different? You watch over the children of Ordon, I swear it. They shall never encounter danger while I breathe. I will take full responsibility for them until they return safely to their village. You need not worry for them. Alright, so, I guess, well, he is the village priest and all that, so he's a kind-hearted soul. So, Let's go grab the int, because I know where it is now. I remember it after a while. And I think after that, we'll end the episode off here. So yeah, one more thing to grab, and we got to do a little bit more exploring here in Kakariko Village. Get those rupees I was talking about before. And after that... Actually, you know what? Can we get rupees? I'm pretty sure we have to blow this... rock away. I don't know if Barnes is selling his bombs just yet. So, I'm pretty sure he does, though. I think the minimum requirement to getting bombs is to defeat the King Bulblin, which we just did. But the ant is out here in the graveyard, so let's just go grab it quick. And then we'll call it an episode. And I believe it's kind of over here somewhere. Oh, real quick. Two torches. Obviously, there's a present here, or a treasure chest here. Yeah, this is kind of a staple of the series. You want to see two torches next to each other, light them up, you might get something good. Here we got a treasure chest. So, let's see what's inside. What could it be? It's a purple ruby. And that's actually enough for us to buy the Helion Shield, so we might as well do that. And that was not the treasure chest with the rupees I was thinking about before, but it passes. That's enough to get us the... shield, and it's a better shield. And we got the melee ant. It's right under here, beneath this tree here. And go away, Gways. Go away, Gways. There are little birds up there that'll swarm you and attack you. And if you actually kill them all off, they'll actually drop a bunch of rupees. They'll just... Well, that's kind of the wrong way to say it. A bunch of rupees will fall down from the sky when you kill all the Gways, but... Yeah, regardless, I'm going to stop by the mail mart and grab ourselves the Helion Shield. Because you definitely want to get this before going any further. Otherwise, you may end up losing your Ordon Shield. Because, yeah, naturally, with Death Mountain exploding, you can bet there's going to be a lot of fire in that region. And, well, being that the... Ordon Shield is made out of wood, and it warned us of this when we first picked it up. You do not want to be using a wooden shield in a land full of fire. Plus, as you can tell by our status screen, the Helion Shield is the last shield we'll be getting because there's no box to the right of it. So yeah, we got the Helion Shield. We're still doing a wooden sword run, but I did say I would be using the better shield whenever we got to it, and this is our better shield. It's the last sword that shield will actually be getting in the entire game, and well, it pretty much is the same thing except it's immune to fire, whereas the Ordon Shield, well, blocks anything except fire. So regardless, we got our Helion Shield. We'll still be getting that treasure chest with a lot of rupees in it next episode if we can get bombs. Actually, I have no money to buy bombs. What am I saying? So, I guess we're just going to save our game now and try to find some more rupees along the way. But, I guess I'll say this is SIMSteven, also known as Mr. Funeral, signing off. And thanks for watching. See you guys next time.